they're quite large trees, and you can't just plant them all over the garden without reducing the sun. So you've got to limit how much you plant. And you can't plant them all through the food forest and not reduce the number of fruit trees you can fit in. So there's a limit to how many casuarinas you want, like there is for legume trees. They're very straight and erect. They don't take to a coppice quite as well as most legume trees, but you can heavily prune them. And if you prune the trunk halfway down when they're reasonably well grown, they'll grow a double trunk. So they will take heavy pruning. But one thing we found is they're great trellises. So you have food vines that can go up, like say passion fruit or even grape, or climbing yam in the tropics, or choco, chayote, or any of the large climbing vines, you can run them up your casuarina and they become a vertical trellis in the food forest. Don't mind the dogs, they're just rustling around the bamboo here behind me. So you'll hear a funny rustle as they come running around. They like to get active when I'm out here, even if I'm just talking to a camera. Anyway, so I like to put quite a few casuarinas through the food forest, nicely spaced, but I don't want to overstack it. You can put them in a row like legumes, but I would incorporate legumes as well. I wouldn't dominate just one species of casuarina. They're not quite a leucina, where with leucinas you can put just leucinas. Here we go, it's a cup of tea arriving. Look at that, fresh mint tea. Wow, that'll keep me talking. Yes, but not quite as heavily as some of the classic legumes. But there is lots of legume trees that are not so classic that you don't overcrowd as well. You don't want to overcrowd ice cream bean, Inga. You don't want to overcrowd tipus, and they're two of the classics. There's lots of albizias and calandras. So mixing with your casuarina gives you that different shape. It gives you extra phosphate with extra nitrogen from the Frankia bacteria associate, which is different to the rhizobium bacteria associate on legumes. And it gives you that nice top whippy top, which kind of combs the wind on the top edge of the wind. So the bottom of the wind, the top of the windbreak is sort of an interaction between the whippy aerial type spring of the top of the casuarinas. It's kind of nice. It gives you that sort of buffering of the aggressive wind edge. So I like that. And I like the fact they're quite high in silica too, so you get an extra silica component, which again helps you buffer the wind. Seems to be a bit of connection to wind there, really, in with it all.